So you got to do again?
Yes, I'm doing it again right now. Okay. You'd be amazed how many times I have to shoot these. Right, here we are at Lulai Temple, East Entrance. Here's the gentleman who just spoke, who let me in. Here's a nice man. Look at that. A very smart nod there from the chap. All jolly green. Now, this one is close to the other two temples I've done today, hence the menage a trois of temples. Also, you can see the sun heading down in the west there, because it's getting on a bit. So let's crack on, shall we? Right, obviously a smaller one. And all this plastic here, let's have a peek underneath, shall we? Peeky, peeky, poos. Okay, what we can see, obviously, is archaeological work. Digging up some foundation stones and stuff there. But before we nip into there, let's go and have a look at the view over here. This looks rather nice. Right, I don't take you into the pagodas much, so I will just do that now. Here you go. Now, you get one of these, you can hear the echo, can't you? Pretty much every temple, because the holiness, the worship venue is still there. So isn't that fantastic, isn't it? It really is. It's all hand-painted and everything, of course, and it's very impressive, this one. It's nice and fresh, it's new. There's plenty of old ones, but this has been looked after very well. Now off to the temple. Right, what we seem to have is four of these larger complexes. Obviously, they're doing restoration work. You see all that scaffolding? These things are tall. I wish, well, you can never really appreciate how tall and how big these things are. But there's a couple of features I've noticed already. Now, you could see, well, actually amongst them, that gentleman there, who'll be a royal person, probably the king, he's not in such good nick. But if we scan across to this lady here, who's probably a queen, she is in fantastic nick. And that's because she's been protected by the other building. And you don't see them that good. Again, we're seeing the ancient script. Oops, as I climb up here. Oh, so scaffolding. The ancient script on the doors, which is also extremely well preserved. Really, really well preserved. Now look at it. That is, yeah, that is remarkable. This one has been protected by the others, because the others aren't in such good condition. Oh, God, ow. Oh, blimey. So although covered in scaffolding, they all have their unique quality, but I can't tell you how blinking tall that is. Look at it. It just keeps going up and up and up. These things are pretty damn big. And some poor bugger has to climb up them to weed them, because trees and everything keep taking root. Now, we can see what's happened to his brethren here. He's basically disappearing rapidly, as is his cousin to the side here. So they've shored these two up. They're almost given up the ghost on these, unfortunately. But the other four are getting the attention. And again, we're getting the inscription on the inside. These have usually been stolen. I think that's, you know, but for some reason around this way, they haven't stolen them, which is rather good. So there you go. Another group of temples that are away from the usual Siem Reap Center main complex ones. I'll tell you the truth, I'm bloody knackered. Oh, it's been a long day. Right, let's take the ending shots and then stick it up on the interweb.